Hey everyone. So we'll start off with our first example. We're looking at what says, according to the NIH, a person is obese if his or her body mass index, BMI, is 30 or above. In a simple random sample of 800 college-age adults, 18 through 24, 96% of the subjects, 96 of the subjects were found to be obese. So we're asked to compute a 95% confidence interval by hand for the proportion of all college-age adults who are obese. All right, so the first thing we should do here is figure out what our p hat is. So let's find p hat. P hat should be this 96 subjects that they give you that were found to be obese, and it should be divided by the 800. All right, so this is our proportion. So 96 over 800. And my calculator gets me 0.12. Okay, if we have p hat for proportions, then we should definitely find what q hat is. So q hat is just actually 1 minus your p hat. So in this case, it'll be 1 minus 0.12, which is 0.88. All right, and next we're looking at a 95% confidence interval. This is what the question is asking us to figure out. So this means that our critical value, our z asterisk, is equal to 1.96. So this is a value that you're probably just given a table of values for it, for 90%, 95%, and 99%. So the corresponding value for 95% is 1.96. All right, so next we're going to figure out the margin of error. And the margin of error is basically our z asterisk times the square root of p hat times q hat all divided by n. All right, so that gives us 1.96 times, and we said p hat was 0.12 and q hat was 0.88, and we divide that by our 800. All right, now taking some time, just crunching those numbers in the calculator, we should get approximately 0.023. All right, so we found our margin of error. So to calculate the confidence interval for a proportion, we're going to take p hat plus and minus our z asterisk times the p hat times q hat over n. All right, so for us, we're gonna have 0.12, and it's gonna be minus 0.023 and 0.12 plus 0.023. All right, so crunching those values, we should get 0.097 and 0.143. All right, so here's the confidence interval. And basically from this, we're saying that, let's type this in, we can say that we are 95% confident that proportion of all college-age students, that are obese is between 0.097 and 0.143. Okay, so our next example takes us into this situation. A psychology professor is interested in determining the proportion of students at her college that suffer from depression. She randomly selects 400 students and finds that 45 suffer from depression. So we're asked to calculate the margin of error for a 99% confidence interval. All right, so it looks like here we're going to have to figure out the proportion, our p hat, and that's going to be using the 45 over the 400 total amount of students. So that gives us 0.1125. All right, and in finding q hat, we just take 1 minus p hat. So that's going to be 1 minus 0.1125. And crunching those numbers in the calculator gets us 0.8875. Next, we'll plug into the formula for margin of error. So our formula is as such. It's E is equal to our z asterisk, which is 2.575, and it's multiplied times the square root of the product of p hat and q hat, so that's 0.1125 times 0.8875. And that product is divided by n. Our n value for this problem is 400. So crunching the numbers in the calculator, it's approximately 0.041. So the margin of error is 0.041. All right, so in this example, it says that a random sample of 500 nursing school applications were selected, and it was noted if the applicant was a male or female. The results are noted below. So they have female as 432 and male 68. We're asked to construct a 99% confidence interval for the proportion of all nursing school applicants that are men. Okay, so we're gonna solve this with the technology. We're gonna use StatCrunch. First, we should probably find out our p hat, that proportion. So it looks to be that we're using that 68, right? 68 over the entire amount, which is 500, because we're looking at the proportion of nursing school applicants that are men. So 68 over 500. Okay, so using our chosen technology of StatCrunch will make it easy for us. So we work through it by going to the tab Stat, our Stat tab. We go down to Proportion Stats, go over to One Sample, and then here with Summary, right? Because our problem gave us the data summarized in the quick short table. So I enter that. Number of successes we said was 68. Number of observations was 500. We just need to go down to confidence interval. Click on confidence interval for P. The level is at 95% right now, but our problem said 99%. So we just change it to 0.99. We hit compute, and there you can see the output that's given by StatCrunch. So here we have the lower limit, 0.0965 and 0.1754. So I'll just copy and paste the StatCrunch output right here. So our confidence interval will be 0.097 to 0.175. Okay, so then after that, I'll just write a quick statement. The statement will say that we are 99% confident that the proportion of all nursing school applicants that are men is between 0.097 and 0.175. So our last problem says that a research company for large retailers wants to know what percentage of shoppers use credit cards. So how many randomly selected shoppers must they survey in order to estimate the proportion of shoppers who use credit cards within 3.5% with 95% confidence? Well, we already know the margin of error formula, right? As Z asterisk, and this is multiplied times the square root of the product of P hat and Q hat, all divided by N. So what we're going to need to solve for is N, right? Because we're trying to find that value, how many randomly selected shoppers that they must survey. We're going to have to solve for that. So I'm just going to solve for that and then begin plugging into what I've found. So the first thing I would do here is go ahead and divide both sides by Z asterisk. So then we'll have E over Z asterisk is equal to the square root of the product of P hat and Q hat over N. It's a radical equation, so I can use that principle of power and square both sides. This helps to get rid of that radical. I'll get E squared over Z asterisk squared is equal to P hat times Q hat, that product over N, right? Gets rid of the radical for me. And now I look at it and I have a proportion, a ratio equal to another ratio. I can go ahead and cross multiply there. I get E squared times N. And that's equal to Z asterisk squared times that product of P hat and Q hat. All right, knowing that I'm solving for N, I'm just gonna go ahead and divide both sides by E squared. Divide this side as well by E squared. And then I'm left with N is equal to Z asterisk squared times the quantity, times the product, excuse me, of P hat and Q hat all over E squared. Okay, so from here, now I can just go ahead and substitute in. So our Z asterisk that corresponds to 95% will be 1.96. We square that. So here, we're going to assume that P hat and Q hat are both 50%, right? You should always assume that if not given within your problem. So we're going to say 0.5 times 0.5. And then this is all divided by E squared, which is the margin of error squared. And we were told it's 3.5%, so you just have to change it into a decimal. So it's 0.035, and then don't forget to square it. Okay, and then crunching these numbers in the calculator, that top you get about 0.9604, and the bottom, the denominator is 0.001225. So dividing that quotient is 784 shoppers